Some time ago, I made a video called Android Application Pinning Bypass, where I explained how to bypass certificate pinning on rooted Android devices. The technique works well when applications are allowed to run on such type of devices. However, sometimes it is not possible, as in the case of today's challenge, named Anchored. In this challenge, there is a protection mechanism that prevents the execution of the app on rooted devices. The challenge says, a client asked me to check if I can intercept the HTTPS request and get the value of the secret parameter that is passed along with the user's email. The application is intended to run in a non-rooted device. Can you help me find a way to intercept this value in plain text? Before starting, if you enjoyed the video at any point or you find it interesting, please let me know it with a comment and dropping a like. And if you're new here and you're interested in other content like this, I invite you to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new content. Having said that, are you ready to discover how to defeat certificate pinning on non-rooted devices? Let's get started. Anchored is an easy difficulty mobile challenge from the intro to Android exploitation track on HackTheBox. The README text file contained within the challenge archive suggests to install the application on an Android version prior to Android 10 that includes Google Play services and without root privileges. As for every Android challenge, the first thing I do is decompile the APK using APKTool and analyze the contents of the AndroidManifest.xml file, searching for the min SDK version field, which tells us the minimum Android version on which the application can run. Luckily, the field has not been specified, meaning that every version is supported, and so we can use an old version of Android if needed. Even if the challenge explicitly says to not use rooted version of Android, I want to see what happens when we install the application on such type of devices. So let's start an Android 6 emulator having root privileges and let's see how the APK behaves. The application does not even start. It closes immediately, printing several alerts saying that it has identified a rooted device. Okay, let's go back to the challenge suggestion and use a non-rooted device. For a bit of variety, this time I decide to use my physical testing device, a Nacer Liquid, instead of an emulated one. In order to install the APK through ADB, I first enable the USB debug, then I connected my device to ADB, and finally I installed the APK using ADB install. Perfect, the application pops out and starts automatically, showing us just a simple image form that once compiled only prints a text message. At the moment, there is not much else we can do, except try to intercept application HTTP request. The setup is pretty much the same used for pinned, so check that video to understand how certificate validation works and how to correctly import certificates on Android. Once imported BARPSIP certificates, let's set up our attacker machine as an HTTP proxy and let's see if we are able to intercept the exchanged request without having to do anything. Obviously, we are not, so let's try to decompile the application using bytecode viewer and understand if we can bypass certificate validation injecting FRIDA within the application or if we are able to bypass root detection and so attack the application as we did for pinned. Then, neither JDGuy nor JDX were able to successfully decompile the application, which is very obfuscated. If we search the message shown by the application, we obtain many results all equals, while if we look for some references to certificate pinning or root detection mechanism, we found nothing useful. In this scenario, using FRIDA is almost impossible. Sure, FRIDA can be injected through FRIDA gadgets inside regular application also on non-rooted devices, but it requires to modify and rebuild the application's MALI. Not a very convenient practice for particularly obfuscated codes like this one. Moreover, we should also have to identify the function to hook, which we have not found yet and which is very complex to locate inside all of this stuff, so we have to find a different approach. While documenting online, I discovered the existence of the networksecurityconf.xml file, a particular file used by applications to customize their network security settings in a safe, declarative configuration file without modifying application code, providing different capabilities including certificate pinning. To use this configuration, however, applications must include an entry in Android Manifest, and our application did it. Let's see what's inside. It seems a pretty default configuration, like the one documented by Google. It trusts a particular self-signed certificate located in row certificate for the domain anchored.com and all its subdomains, but it does not implement any sort of pinning, as proved by the absence of pin set and pin tags. Looking at the documentation, we can see that certificates can contain both value system as well as user to specifically trust system or user installed certificates. We can also see that starting from Android 7.0, user installed certificates have been removed from the default trust configuration, explaining why it was possible to use user certificates on Android 6 and lower, but not on Android 7 and later versions. Okay, now that we have understood how this file works, we can edit it to force the application into trusting our custom certificate. To ensure that this modification works, we add both system and user certificates and also force the pinning override. Perfect, now that we have modified the application components, we can rebuild the application into a new one, as I better explained inside the video reverse and patch an easy APK. Once finished, if we want that Android accept the newly created APK, we have to sign it. First, we must create a sign-in key using KeyTool, then we have to sign the archive using jar signer. In this way, Android will trust our application and will allow us to execute it. We are ready. If we try to install the new application, we get an error because the original one is still installed. We have to uninstall it first and then install the patched one. The application starts without problems, meaning that so far we have done everything correctly. Now, if we open Barbsuit and push request access from the patched APK, we should be able to intercept application requests and read the secret flag. Untrusted certificates. This was my solution for Anchored. Were you already aware of the network security conf.xml file, or do you know other techniques to solve this challenge? Let me know it in the comment section below. Thanks to everyone who stayed with me up to here. I hope you enjoyed the video and that you find it useful. If so, please consider leaving me a like and subscribe to the channel so that we can meet again in the next video. Having said that, see you next time. Ciao.